Well, Tony, is this the end of the U.S. or the beginning of Mexico? What's going on?
Well, from here, I have to run back to where I started this morning in El Cajon. And then tomorrow I'm running towards the Mexican border. So I've actually ran 4,950 miles in total since the journey began on October the 25th in Dublin with the Dublin Marathon. And I've approximately another 50 miles in the US. But this was here was ocean to ocean, from the Atlantic to the Pacific. And so from here I'm going down to Mexico. And I'm going to run through Mexico, Central America, South America, and that'll be roughly the halfway mark on this journey, which I actually underestimated in miles. It's going to be about 31,000 miles or 50,000 kilometers, and it'll probably take a total of 4 years. I've been on for all 7 months now, so still quite a long way to go. That's continent number one scratched off, North America. Now for South America. And I don't believe the adage anymore that it's a small world. And when you're running, it's a huge world. But it's full of people with huge hearts. It's incredible people out there. It's, the world is full of great people. There's only a few bad people, really, is what I'm starting to believe. And this journey would not have been possible without the help of the people in the United States. Wonderful people. It's really a remarkable country. I'm so happy. In many ways, I'm sad I'm finishing in the country, but I had such a great time here, and I'm so happy. I'm just overwhelmed with hitting the ocean here today. This is wonderful. But in my mind, I have this snapshot. It's like I've been taking this live movie snapshots every 10, 15 miles, all the way from when I crossed the border from Canada into Maine just before Christmas. And I just, all the way, I just kept meeting incredible people. And I didn't even have one single rude comment, actually, on the whole journey I had. And just about everybody I met has been incredible. There were times when I had problems with blizzards in Maine and the New England area, and people stopped and brought me into their homes. There was other times when I was bold enough, I just went up to farms and asked, would I sleep in their barns or their garages? And almost always they said yes. People are just wonderful. And a long way to continue. But as I say, this is wonderful. Yeah. white Mangan socks.
Right now, Global Ireland Metro Team. I'm actually going back to Ireland on Thursday, going back for time out. I believe that's the best way to do this. It's mentally, as well as physically, very, very, very tough. Because I've no support group. I have to coordinate with people that are helping me and try and organise things on the road. So I'm going back for a short time, 3 weeks, and I'm continuing on the exact spot where I left off in the next war. Always came up smiling because distances to hook you up with the whole of the mountain of the highway, where you might finish on a mile mark, whatever it is, and photograph and log it, and then return from that to that exact same spot the next day. So people have offered to drive 20 miles for the miles, and they have to do that mile for 4 times, out of the evening, bring me back, and then back in the morning, and come on. And this time it's my gas price, and I'm trying to log it, it's running, running all the day, so you can drive, and they're driving incredible distances, help me out, and it's just incredible.
Congratulations, Tony.